Hello and thanks for joining me, Mick, on abrittogo. Now, I am really excited today because we are reviewing this little beauty. So, first thing, this is not an expensive guitar. This guitar retails at, I think it's $599. I bought it from Sweetwater, where, as you know, I get a lot of my stuff from. I bought this in 2020, I think March of 2020. But this is, well, before I tell you what it is, there are two things that make this guitar special, even though it's cheap, relatively cheap. There are two things that make it special, and these are the two things. This and this. That's right. Johnny Cash and Martin Guitars, the collaboration. This is the Martin DX Johnny Cash. It is a laminated top, sides and back, and I never get that the right way around, do I? Top, back and sides. It's all laminate. When I bought this, or when I was thinking about buying it, I was a little bit concerned about the laminate. Is it gonna sound good? You hear a lot of stories, you know, purists think no wood sounds better, others, you know, have a different opinion. At this price, and as a fan of Johnny Cash, I thought I have got to give it a go. I have got to try it out. At $599, it was a no-brainer. And you know what? I was going to do an unboxing video when I got it, but I was so excited to get it out of the box. I got it out, and it was more or less in tune, but I got it out the box, did the finite tuning on it, and just started messing around with it, and then thought, damn, I should have done an unboxing video. Too late, sorry. I'm not going to go back and tape it all up and then pretend to unbox it. So I didn't anyway. But I got it out, an absolutely superb guitar. It has Fishman MX Electronics on board in there, so we can plug it through an amp, and which we will do to give a demo and try out what it sounds like plugged in. It's a dreadnought body, which means that if you were playing it for a while, if you are Mick and you're playing it for a while, after a little while this arm starts to hang off and fall over the floor because it gets tiring. It is a tiring guitar to play. All dreadnoughts for me are a tiring guitar to play. So it's not this one, it's all of them. But nevertheless, this one, it only comes in one color. It comes in, what else would it come in? The Man in Black. The Man in Black, that's the only color you can get it in, is black. Black and white. But it has a few sweet little features. It has the rosette, the white rosette with Johnny Cash's imprinted signature on there. It has the name Cash. As you, if I move my hand out the way, you can see it right on there, as if you needed anybody looked at that and thought, why have they wrote Cash on a guitar? Really? You shouldn't be going anywhere near guitars if you have to ask that question. And then it has, for the dots down the fretboard, it has these stars. Can't imagine why they would put stars for somebody who's as big a star as Johnny Cash, would you? So anyway, I think this was made actually in collaboration with Johnny Cash's family, where they wanted to put together an instrument that was for the Johnny Cash fans, but less expensive than the one that Martin already do, because they already do a dreadnought Johnny Cash special, but that is sometimes more expensive than this is. I can't remember exactly how much it is, but I think we're in four figures. I think we're well into four figures in actual fact. The nice part about the laminate is you can knock it. It's not affected by climate, so whether you live in a humid, a cold, a warm, a dry climate, it does not affect it whatsoever. It stays as sweet as it, you know, regardless of where you are. What it also means is it stays in tune better because it's not affected in movement by the climate. So I have less problems having to tweak it in tune, and don't scold me for this, but I think these are the original strings, the Martin strings that came with it. So I'm due to change them. So for the purpose of the review, however this sounds, think how much nicer it would even sound if it had new strings on, because I'm pretty sure I've not changed strings in this. Now, this is the sound you're hearing there is coming from the guitar. It's not plugged in. It's not plugged in. But look, this is pure acoustic. But the microphone that's picking it up is up here on my lapel. So you're a long way from the sound hole, and I am going to do a sound test in the sound hole. But beautiful sound. That $600 sounds as almost as good as any instrument that I've got. It really does. It feels so good. It is so sturdy, again because of the laminate. It's got a sweet sound. If I had one criticism, if you've seen my video on the Martin 0015M Streetmaster, I did say on there that it felt really easy to play, that the strings were easy to hold down, barring was easier, because I've only been playing 3 years, remember? So it was very forgiving. This is the opposite end of the scale. This I find barring more difficult to do, and the action's low. The action's not particularly high anywhere. But it's not as forgiving, although it sounds, in my opinion, it sounds better than the Streetmaster. It's hard, you've got to work harder to get those notes. So if you're knocking another string, or not quite holding a string down, you might get a bit of a dull noise, or a little bit of fret buzz. It makes you work harder for it. But you know what? It's worth it because if you work hard and you get your cord nice and clean, sounds beautiful. Now, it comes with a gig bag. It's a soft gig bag. It's not the gig bag that you would typically get with higher priced Martin guitars, but it is still a nice, fairly padded gig bag. It has the JC emblem, or the JC name on the front. It has cash on the front of it. But it's not quite as thick. But again, $5.99. What do you expect? Inside we have scalloped X bracing, and the neck is a black birch laminate with a, what's the fingerboard made from? Why am I pointing up there with fingerboard? This is a fingerboard. Let's go find out what the fingerboard's made from. The fingerboard's made from rich light. See, I went and checked for you. The fingerboard's made from rich light. Now, one of the things that they recommend when you get this guitar is that you use a bigger pick, because of the difficulty. So I have a bigger pick here that I'm gonna use this is the new Hard Rock guitar picks. Really expensive picks, these. I'm only kidding. This pick's actually a badge from Hard Rock. Hard Rock in Punta Cana, but this was a name badge that I managed to borrow temporarily from one of them. So I'm not actually. You know what? Let's try it. It's hard to hold on to for a start. You gotta try these things, right? So it also has closed gear tuners. Let's get a look at those. Look at these. Oh, I've gone all blurry in the background. There we go. closed gear tuners. It's the future, I tell you. It's the future. High pressure laminate. Workhorse, sturdy. Can't scratch it. You know, the only thing that's scratched on this guitar is the black gloss pickguard from me scratching it as I'm going down. There is not another mark anywhere on this guitar. I don't think it's a beginner's guitar, just because, like I said, you have to work that little bit harder. But I've been playing 3 years, so I think, you know, if you've been playing for a little while, 6 months to a year, maybe not even that, and then I think it's a worthwhile investment. It's not made in the US. It is made in Mexico. See if we can get a close up on that. So it's not made in the Pennsylvania facility in the US, but at $599, you're not going to get a Martin guitar made in the US, I don't think. Martin DX Johnny Cash. I hope you liked this video. I hope you liked the guitar. I hope it sounded okay for you. I hope I did a good job. Who knows? If you like this video, please give it a little like. I appreciate the thumbs up. And if you're feeling generous, why not even subscribe to the channel? I already have a couple of guitar reviews on there. This will be the third one at the time of filming. I have more to record and put on, and I've also got a new 12 string guitar being delivered in less than a week, so hopefully I'll be doing an unboxing and a review of my first ever 12 string. So thank you all for joining, thank you all for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and this is abrittogo, and I'm gonna go. See ya. Goodbye, farewell. I can't sing either.